Good morning, student. In previous lecture, we have started measurement of self-inductance, in which we have studied about Maxwell inductance bridge and Maxwell inductance capacitance bridge, which is also known as Wien's bridge. In this lecture, we will study about one more method for the measurement of self-inductance bridge, that is AC bridge. Hayes AC bridge. This is a modification of Maxwell-Wien's bridge, which may be used for the inductors where the phase angle is very large. The bridge is balanced by varying C4 and R4. We can also make this C4 as constant and by varying this R4 and R3, we can find the unknown self-inductance L1 and R1 also. This is the equivalent circuit diagram of Hayes bridge. Coming to the vector diagram of Hayes bridge, in this diagram we have I1, I2 and I3, I4 is not in phase with each other. Like in previous cases, we have I1, I2 and I3, I4 are on the same line by making the variable impedance adjustment. We have make I1 and I3 on the same line, but in Hayes bridge we have some phase difference between I1, I2 and I3, I4. Now we'll make a line in phase with I1, I2, I1, that is I1, R1. From this 90 degree apart, we have I1, omega, L1. The resultant of this I1, R1 and I1, omega, L1 will give us V1. And we know that V1, volt potential difference V1 is equals to V3. So we have V1 is equals to V3 is equals to I3, R3. Now on the same line we will have I3 equals to I4, and if we extend this up to some point, we have I4, R4. Now I4, R4 is the potential across this R4. So for getting potential V4 in total, will have I4, R4, and apart from this I4, R4, from this if we have taken 90 degree, we'll have I4 divided by omega C4. The resultant of this two, I4, R4 and I4 omega divided by omega C4, will have V4. So on this line we'll have V4, that is equals to V2, and V2 is equals to I2, R2. So we have V4 and V3. So for making a resultant potential difference V, we can have like line parallel to this V4 here and line parallel to this line V3 here, and the resultant will give us V. Coming to bridge balance condition, we'll have Z1 is equals to R1 plus J omega L1, Z2 is equals to R2, Z3 is equals to R3, Z4 is equals to R4 plus of, but the sign convention of this capacitance will give us minus of J omega C4. Actually we have J in denominator, so we multiply and divide, so we'll get overall minus of J in numerator and divided by omega C4. From the bridge balance condition, we'll have Z1, Z4 is equal to Z2, Z3. Putting all the above values in this equation, we'll get R1 plus J omega L1 multiply by R4 minus of J divided by omega C4 equals to R2, R3. Solving this equation, we'll get equation 11 like this: R1, R2, एल वन सी डिवाइड बाय सी फोर प्लस जे ओमेगा एल वन आर फोर माइनस जे आर वन डिवाइडेड बाय ओमेगा सी फोर इक्वल्स टू आर टू आर थ्री सेपरेटिंग द रियल एंड इमेजिनरी पार्ट फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन विल हैव आर वन आर फोर प्लस एल वन डिवाइडेड बाय सी फोर इज इक्वल्स टू आर टू आर थ्री एंड एल वन इज इक्वल्स टू आर वन ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर फोर सी फोर सो इन दिस इक्वेशन विल हैव लाइक इन दिस इक्वेशन एल वन एंड आर वन बोथ आर अननोन क्वान्टिटीज सो वी हैव टू पुट वैल्यू ऑफ एल वन इन दिस इक्वेशन विल गेट आर वन एंड आफ्टर फाइंडिंग आर वन विल पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर वन इन दिस इक्वेशन सो विल गेट द एल वन सो फॉर सॉल्विंग बोथ द इक्वेशंस दिस एंड दिस विल हैव एल वन इज इक्वल टू आर टू आर थ्री सी फोर डिवाइडेड बाई वन प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर सी फोर स्क्वायर आर फोर स्क्वायर एंड सिमिलरली विल गेट द आर वन ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर टू आर थ्री आर फोर सी फोर स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई वन प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर सी फोर स्क्वायर आर फोर स्क्वायर द क्वालिटी फैक्टर क्यू फैक्टर इज ओमेगा एल वन डिवाइडेड बाई आर वन सो डिवाइडिंग बोथ इक्वेशन विल हैव ओमेगा q is equals to 1 plus omega c4 r4 the equations of unknown l1 and r1 contains frequency terms therefore it appears that the frequency of the source of supply to the bridge must be accurately known this is not true for the inductance when the high q coil is being measured so for explanation in this will have L1 is equals to R2 R3 C4 divided by 1 plus R omega square C4 square R4 square but will have Q is equals to 1 divided by omega C4 and R4 inserting this in this equation of L1 will have L1 is equals to R2 R3 C4 divided by 1 plus square of 1 divided by Q So for values of q greater than 10, the term 1 plus 1 divided by q whole square will be smaller than 1 by 100th and this can be neglected. So the overall equation reduces to L1 is equals to R2, R3, C4. Here is the equation. This equation is same as for Maxwell-Wien's bridge L1, unknown value of self-inductance L1. Advantages and disadvantages of this Hayes bridges. Coming to the advantages, this bridge gives very simple expression for unknown inductance for high values of Q and is suitable for coils having the Q greater than 10. This bridge also gives a simple expression for Q factor. If we examine the expression of Q factor, that is Q is equals to 1 plus omega 1 divided by omega C4 R4, we find that the R4 appears in the denominator. So the Q high Q coil, its value should be small. Thus, this bridge requires only low value of resistor for R4, where in the case of Maxwell bridge, we require a parallel resistor R4 and its value is also high. But in this Hayes bridge case, we have R4, we can have R4 of low resistor value. The disadvantage of this Hayes bridge is it is suited for the measurement of high Q inductors, especially those inductors having Q greater than 10. For inductors having Q smaller than 10, the term 1 by Q square in the expression of L1 becomes rather important and thus cannot be neglected. Hence, this bridge is not suited for the measurement of coils having Q less than 10 and for these application, Maxwell's bridge is more suited. So we have learned about the Hayes bridge. For now I am ending this video. In next lecture we will study about the Adanson bridge, which is also the part of measurement of self-inductance. and that will be the last part of measurement of self inductance. For any queries related to this topic, you can write. Till then, continue your lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.